Alright, I guess this evening I don't know, I can't sleep, so I'm going to, I don't know, show off my little sculptures I made, I don't know, when I guess almost 20 years now, 22 years ago. So I'm thinking maybe this is a direction for my future, perhaps I could be a sculptor. She looks like she's something to sculpt. That I would turn into like a bronze or something. But yeah, this is my young life when I made her. She's the thin one. Now I have a thin one. But yeah, this is many years, and so they're cracked and broken. Yeah, she's kind of beautiful. She's the good-looking one, actually. But yeah. She's the thin one. Okay, now I have the real fatty. I was gonna show the pottery also, but since I'm getting all into all of this ridiculous. What did I do when I was a little child? Well. Okay, so this one is more. She's heavier. She's much heavier. She's a thicker-legged one. I wanted to work on her with like a Dremel or something, more sandpaper, but I didn't have the time. I was moving to Alaska at the moment, and so there it is. But yeah, she's kind of a pretty one also. So yeah, so she's my little, another sculpted one. And so what else I have? I have this other one. Now she was in a house for many years, and she got cracked and broken. Her legs were broken, her arms have been busted, and her hand fell off. So she's had a rough life, but she's, you know, oddly, she's still kind of able and skilled to be kind of stiff dancer. But yeah, she's a little more extreme. She has longer legs, and I guess she looks better from the distance. Maybe you can tell. And she's kind of a pretty one. Yeah. They're stiff though, they don't move, you know. They're not like the real ballet dancers. You can't really manipulate them the same way. But anyhoot. I'm not sure this is working. But yeah, to fix a sculpty after it's all been broken and cracked, I don't think you can. But yeah, I don't know. It's kind of an odd talent. So maybe we have sculptor in the family, running in our lines. And there's back to the pottery. When I was a very, very small child, because I was showing my brothers and how talented they were. So here is here's my little tiny bowl. And yeah, I didn't pick anything bright or glazy. Just a very delicate tiny bowl, and that's all, you know, like that. And then what else? I really love the, this is actually one of my favorite techniques, is the coil. So I made the coil, what do you call that? Just a little coil vases. I love the coil vases. So I think I did these when I was maybe 8 years old or seven, or even earlier. Yikes, so I can't believe my mother saved all these things. It's amazing, actually. So now we have the bowl, and here is this one is more Fred Flintstone style, like a little plate dish. So that's kind of a fun one, also. Yeah. So pottery, and then, oh my goodness, and then eventually, I guess back to the Flopsy Bunny made out of stones. It could have been mine, actually. It could have been mine, because I believe this is something that I created. It's a turtle, a simple turtle with Tantrienta, the candle. I'm pretty sure this one is mine. It looks like it would be, anyhow. Anyway, what I was really showing more than anything was the sculpture, and I don't know. That's an idea, because if it runs in the, if already my brother makes the sculpture ideas here and I make the sculptures, then obviously then who else? Probably all of my brothers. And so maybe we are a sculpture family. Maybe we can't help it. Maybe it's something we just cannot stop being able to be skilled at. I mean, it's amazing, really. And so, because I've seen some real cruddy sculpture out there, that somehow, you know, people purchase sometimes. So yeah. So Leslie, I'll show her. She's in that chic Chagallian look, isn't she? I love her face, actually. If you could see her closer, yeah, she's at that chic Chagall. She has that going on. Tantria, kind of ghostish. But yeah, off to ballet. All right, girls, stop.